whatever you do.
Hey, it's Brett here, Mountain Bike More, and I want to help you ride Snow Valley. I already did a video on the green runs. Those are called beginner runs. This is going to be the blue runs or the intermediate runs. But I will want to share something my son observed. He said, hey, these trails aren't rated as high as they could be. So the green runs, the beginner runs, are pretty challenging for beginner runs. The blue runs or the intermediate runs are pretty challenging for the intermediate runs. And we even make it more challenging on ourselves just to have more fun. So I hope you like this. Ask me questions. Watch over and over again. Don't be shy. Mountain Bike More.
Bandit. We've moved on to the intermediate trail. We're on the blues now. Stepping up from the greens. The greens are not the true easy beginner runs, but they're not that hard either. We do expect a little bit more spice. Still they're intermediate level, not advanced level, but look at this tight berm section. And loose dirt makes that a little sketchier. And then we're gonna go left here, continue on Bandit. These berms flow so well this year. What's that?
Dad, are you supposed to be able to gap that?
I don't know.
How is it?
All right, in pure Snow Valley fashion, there's all sorts of little optional obstacles that are really cool if you know them. I blew it by not carrying speed through here. There's a rock up high to the right. Advanced feature on the blue run. And then I just had that little optional thing. Oh shit! That was not the plan! Alright, in pure Snow Valley fashion, there's all sorts of little optional obstacles that are really cool if you know them. I blew it by not carrying speed through here. There's a rock up high to the right. Advanced feature on the blue run. And then I just had that little optional thing. There's another one right here. So, really fun trail if you have a mixed level of riders. Beginner intermediate riders just stay on the dirt. More advanced riders get a little more playful. But even that was tricky. And then these rocks are painted red to kind of make them easier for you to see. So that was kind of a chunky spot for an intermediate rider. As you'll learn, the faster, the easier those things become. But if you don't know what's there, you don't want to go too fast because you'll get in over your head quickly. And then here's a soft little berm. A little bit of chunk on the berms. You all good? Yeah, he's never been through that section before. Some rocks to kind of deal with. They wouldn't call this an intermediate trail if you couldn't just roll everything, so have confidence in that. And just got a bunch of speed, so using my brakes, slow myself down. Little brake berm, these things are real grippy. This place just puts a smile on your face. It's different if you're a snow summit rider or if you pedal trails, because you're just like on a home trail with berms, dirt, rocks, jumps, all here. These trails are about 2 miles in length, typically, give or take. Yep, keep going to Mambo Corral. And up here on the right is a rock drop. And you don't have to hit that. And that wood thing is really cool. All right, so Mambo Corral, crazy horse. It goes maybe 100 yards until it meets back up with Fool's Gold, so keep an eye out. Little rock pop. So this is blue, they're all blue today. Soft berm. And then here we go, we meet it with Fool's Gold. There's a little jump here on the left for us. Whew. Tire got a little swishy. This corner, a little sketch-a-rama for me, because it gets narrow and soft. All right, we're looking for jumps. They're definitely optional. That one's super fun. This next one I go a little long on sometimes, so I gotta be careful, because it has steep landing. And this one, it's fun, there we go. All right, crazy horse. Now this one has a little bit of spice for a blue trail. So watch for rocks. Not smooth as can be. There are some rocks you have to worry about, or not worry about, but be able to ride. Look how soft this is. And then here's an optional rock drop. Whee! You can thread the needle and not have a problem there. Here's a rock. It's a super soft turn. Here's another one. A little optional. Boop. But you gotta get back on the trail. Oh, deep. That's the sand they tell you to worry about or pay attention to. I don't know if the camera picked up that little slide. I heard a whoa. All right, I'm hearing holy cow up top. We'll have to find out what happened. Whew. Crazy horse. And then it's just the bottom section. It's soft, some rolls, some jumps, whatever you want. Merges here with Fool's Gold. There's some optional berms. It looks like everyone's skipping nowadays. There's a wood drop that's kind of fun. Or you can squash it. And there we have it. Crazy horse. Winchester. Ooh. Sun is in your eyes. Blue square with large jumps. There's definitely a large jump section down here. But the upper part is definitely a blue intermediate trail. And we'll see how much of the trail we can actually see. That was optional. So is that. That's what's so cool about Snow Valley is you just have all these options of different ways to go about things. It's kind of a playground, but longer trails. Look, you got a drop or just a roll on the berm. Oh, that berm was good. Those were really good berms. Granted, you can't see too well, so you hope it's good. Oh, right in the sun. Total blind. Oh my gosh. Oh, sorry, that was just ridiculous. Dumb. All right, let's see what we can come up with here. Oh, I can't see. Oh. All right, so here comes a jump on the right. I don't remember this one too well. Perfect, smooth, smooth. That was big. All right. All right, take the inside line. All right, inside line makes this next jump easy. And that was where it got spicy. Little rutted out turn. So Winchester, take a look at those jumps. Don't send them. We've been here before. You can go fast. Boop. And now we're at the Mambo Corral. Oh. All right, so a little after 6:30, the shadows started to get a little rough, just so you're ready for it. We're going down Sundance over the little jump run, gonna hit the Blue Cannon, maybe call it a day, we'll see. Right now we're just on the traverse. Don't go too crazy on this thing, because consequence if you go off left is pretty severe. And it does get narrow in one little section. Okay, maybe in two. That felt a little narrow. But we're getting a little more comfortable here. Rolling down. Traverse. Woo! Here's where it gets narrow. You can see how soft it is over to the left. Sure, there's some pretty ugly wipeouts there. Brake rut. Here comes a little jump. You gotta slow down, hit the berm. Trying to drift it and not doing a good job. Oh, that berm was sick.
They're great, they're awesome.
All right, Sundance intermediate jump line area. Starts with some soft berms. Middle jumps. Then up here there's going to be an intersection, so you got to kind of pay attention. Into the trees. A little out of control, having fun. And I missed the intersection, or I called it out too early. There it is. So we're gonna go right here, stay on the intermediate section. Whew, that was loose. Shadow makes it hard to see the texture of the dirt. And we just come out alongside the jumps, but we get our smaller ones. Whew, air to flat. Pop these, roll them, whatever. Manual them. Oh, one last jump, didn't see that thing. And we're back in the lift line. All right, so we take Greenhorn, and there'll be a little bit of a lake coming up here. And when you see that lake, sorry, there it is. That tells you you're getting close to the Sidewinder or whatever. Yeah. Whatever the dual slalom is called. We'll double check on the name. turnoff. But this is a beautiful area of the park. There's the lake, pond. And the turnoff is right next to the Greenhorn Trail, so it's easy to find and follow. We can see it. Sidewinder dual slalom. All right, take it fairly easy. It's our first time. Is it?
I just saw a trout jumping on the other tree. That was the...
All right, so we're gonna adventure into Sidewinder. We've taken it before. We had a blast just playing with it, but we're gonna be safe today. Take it easy, maybe push it a little later. Shadows will start to affect this place later in the day, and that's what we're here. We got stuck in traffic, and the gate is straight ahead next to the second much larger lake. All right. All right, you all set? Sidewinder adventure. We're just gonna take up the whole course this time. Didn't make the first jump. Easy to overshoot the second jump, so take some caution. This could be doubled, I think, but there's three of them. That can be jumped. Don't do that, whatever you do. Oh, take it easy, figure out the course. The pros memorize where to go fast, where to go slow. And we're gonna come out here at Mambo Corral. Oh.
Oh. Don't forget to hit the subscribe, especially if you like this video. Ask questions. Ask me to clarify your questions and your answers. I want to help you ride more.
Mountain bike more. Ride more. Subscribe. Laugh more.
Like. Crash more. Comment.
Crash more. Comment.